A very quick disclaimer, this video is not legal advice. And in this video, I will only be explaining what the law is. I won't be arguing for what it should be. With that said then, let's talk about the composition of parliament in Singapore according to law. In our last video, we talked about the uniquely Singaporean group representation constituency scheme, which makes some voters vote for groups of candidates with at least one candidate in a minority race. In this video, we'll go beyond the idea of voting members of parliament into power. We'll be talking about the two groups of non-elected members of parliament, the non-constituency members of parliament, or NCMPs, and the nominated members of parliament, or NMPs. So, it's worth repeating from our last two videos. The existence of the legislature is constitutional level significant in Singapore. It should be unsurprising then that the people in the legislature, or the composition of parliament, is also constitutional level significant. And that's exactly what it is. Article 39 comprehensively lists out the composition of parliament. But there's one surprising feature of Article 39. Subsection 1 of the article lists not one, but three types of members of parliament. Subsection 1A accounts for the members elected by the people through general elections. But how about subsections 1B and 1C? You see, that's where it gets interesting. Let's start with subsection 1B of the article. It states that along with the elected members, Parliament shall also consist of a maximum of 12 non-constituency members of Parliament, the NCMPs. The name gives it away. The NCMPs don't have a constituency. They simply weren't elected by the people. But let's dive deeper. Subsection 1B also says that the existence of these NCMPs is provided by law. That law refers to Section 52 of the Parliamentary Elections Act, which essentially states that these NCMPs are candidates from opposition parties with the highest percentage of votes in elections without getting elected. That is, the so-called best losers of the elections. Okay, so the NCMPs kinda got elected, but not really. And this is, under Article 39, Subsection 1B, constitutional level significant. Now, let's quickly turn to Subsection 1C. It states that in addition to the elected members and NCMPs, Parliament shall also consist of a maximum of 9 nominated members of Parliament, or NMPs. But what's important is the mode in which NMPs are so-called nominated. Subsection 1C states that they are chosen through appointment by the President in accordance with the 4th Schedule. So we turn to the 4th Schedule to see who these NMPs really are. And under paragraph 3, subparagraph 2 of the 4th Schedule, we see that these NMPs are people with independent and non-partisan views, who have distinguished themselves through various different ways. What it all means is that the Parliament of Singapore consists of two groups of non-elected members, the NCMPs and NMPs. Naturally, the question that follows is, why? Well, that's controversial, and I will not be entering into the fray in this video. However, if you'd like to dig deeper, I've included references to the parliamentary debates surrounding each of these schemes in the description to this video. With that said then, that's all we'll be talking about today. I really hope that this video was helpful for your understanding. In our next video, we'll be talking about what's possibly the most exciting part of elections, political parties. Until then, thank you so much for watching, and please, take care of yourselves.